Blazing hot. Hot. And in the mix with DJ Blaze, the boy wonder.
Beloved, it was with great pain and sorrow I received the news that our dear brother, Apostle Samuel Malambo, had passed away. It was a shock, and it still is a shock. And I think, why does the best always go first? Apostle Malambo was a true man of God. His character, his wisdom, his knowledge, his understanding, his love, his compassion, and his great humor, we will never forget. It was important to me in my life, to the Minister of Africa Israel Initiative, to his family, and to the Kingdom of God. He was a pillar for all of us. As we gather today, I'm with you, though not present in your presence, we know that Apostle Malambo is with God. Our pain is great, but our thankfulness is greater. Thankfulness for the man he was, the life he lived, and the legacy that he left behind. And we have a hope that one day, surely, we will be together where there is no pain and sorrow anymore. Apostle Samuel Malambo has reached his destiny. My heart and love goes up to you, Mama, Mrs. Josephine Malambo especially, and the family in this great time of sorrow. I pray that God himself will give you grace and abundance to go through, and we know his grace is enough for us. We will continue to live with what Apostle Malambo always imprinted in us, that God's grace is enough. I bless you all in the name of Jesus, and we will continue what Apostle Malambo lived. We will fulfill our callings as he now has fulfilled his. God bless you.
Apostle Samuel Malambo was many things. Among them, he was a husband, father, he was a friend, he was a minister, but he was also a great leader. He saw people. He did not distance himself from them, but he always had an encouraging word for everyone. We will honor Apostle Malambo and remember him by showing you a little bit of a speech he had in a TV program we recorded in his beloved Zambia.
Greetings from Africa, Zambia, Southern Africa. This is Apostle Samuel Adam Malambo, the Regional Director for Southern Africa, region for Africa Israel Initiative. Now we are here right in Livingstone, which is the source of the mighty Victoria Falls, the waters that thunder, which is one of the world wonders. And people travel from all over to come here to see. We are right now in the low season. The waters are a bit low, but we are here at least to be able to speak something from this part. Now, we are just coming from Lusaka, the capital city. We have had a very powerful visit by our team from Norway and Israel. We run a network called Africa Israel Initiative, and the purpose of this network is to establish caucuses for parliaments between Israel and Africa. And so we just had a powerful meeting with our parliament in Zambia to be able to negotiate in the establishment of a caucus to build bilateral relations between Israel and Zambia. And so we bless God that through that we are also be able to bring in the church, that we may mobilize the church to arise to the occasion of networking with Israel and also partnering with Israel and being able to support Israel. We, through our initiative, we are able to raise support from here to identify prophetic needs that are in Israel. One of them is the returning of the Jews back home. And so as an initiative, we are facilitating from Africa in order to fulfill the scriptures according to Genesis chapter 12, verse 3. The Bible says, God told Abraham that those who bless him, he shall also bless them. And those who curse him, they also curse them. And so we are an initiative that is connecting Africa with Israel through raising our support, through donations from Africa, to be able to adopt projects in Israel that are able to facilitate the returning of the Jews back. One of the areas is the absorption center, where Jews are trained culture and also the tribe, the Hebrew language. And so through that also, we have the transportation of the Jews for those who are going back home. And also we have the housing scheme where the government builds houses and gives them to them on loan. And so they have to be able to pay for those loans. And so Africa Israel Initiative is one of those organizations that is working towards facilitating all these possibilities to ensure that the prophetic word of the end time is fulfilled, so that we don't just read about it in the Bible, but we realize it and bring it to reality. So recently we just had our president from Africa Israel Initiative, who came from Norway, who was visiting Zambia to meet quite a number of high profile leaders in our government. And also with him was a delegation from Israel. We had the director of the Association of the Knesset, who is establishing Christian caucuses around the world in connection with the Parliament of Israel and Africa and also around the world. And so he came in for them to be able to meet our parliament leaders, and we've also been able to meet some of the government leaders so that we can facilitate that possibility. Right now we have also raised a national team in Zambia that is able to coordinate and put together this initiative. And together, after visiting different courtesy centers and calls, we were able on the Wednesday, the 2nd of December, we gathered at the Southern Sun Hotel in Lusaka for a cocktail reception and farewell party for our leaders who came, so that together we can be able to share the vision and be able to fulfill the mandate for this call. Right now, we thank God. Why Zambia? Zambia is the most country that has been declared as a Christian nation in the whole world. And right now, by the grace of God, we are facilitating as a church and also in partnership with our government to be able to bring that to reality. We realize that 23 years ago, Zambia was declared a Christian nation, and the national second Republican president was able to dedicate our nation to God, so that it becomes a Christian nation, so that Zambia can be able to enter into a covenant. Right now, Zambia is taking a lead in many areas in the issues of the spiritual and also in the realization of the end time fulfillment of what God wants to do. I am one of the examples. I work in the East Africa, and by the grace of God, I've been able to raise a standard for what our nation stands for in that nation. And right now we are slowly working back into Zambia to be able to coordinate a network that from Zambia we can be able to bring the relationship between Zambia and Israel and Africa and Israel to reality. And apart from all, we also send people every year to tour Israel from different nations for the purpose of connecting with the land, so that they can also be able to realize their Christianity and also to see the reality of the Bible from the land of the Bible. Once you travel to Israel, I've been there myself personally. When you enter into the tomb, you go to the place where Jesus in the synagogue, where he declared that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the gospel. The moment you come there, you go to Gethsemane, you go to Galilee, you go to Mount Olives. When you return back, the Bible just becomes real. And so we pray that from Africa shall many nations arise, go to Israel to visit and tour Israel, and also begin to influence parliaments that they can be able to connect with the Caucasus in Israel. And apart from that, that governments of Africa can be able to support Israel in this end time when Israel needs Africa most. We see that from the West, many nations are turning against Israel. Some of them are planning to strategize that they remove them from the world map. But right now, Africa is the hope for Israel. So we pray that African nations will begin to gather in numbers, raise to be able to facilitate this end time mobilization, that we may be able to stand with Israel, just as it was in the time of our Lord Jesus Christ. When the Lord Jesus Christ with his parents were threatened in Israel, they ran to Africa. They came to Egypt, which was a place of refuge. Right now we know that Israel will find its refuge in Africa. And so history is repeating itself, and we pray that many nations will arise and fall suit, as Zambia is already taking away and able to lead. Apart from that, we also establish Africa Revival Summits in different nations every year. The purpose of that is to educate the church in Africa, to empower the church in Africa, to be able to understand the role of the church and the relationship between Israel and Africa. And so now we are calling upon all nations that they may arise to this occasion. From this nation of Zambia, we are partnering with also other nations from all over, and we are using our season very well. For we, as being declared a Christian nation, are also supporting Israel to the fullest, and we are praying that many other nations will be able to follow suit. We want to thank you for listening to this documentary. We pray that you will be able to rise from your nations and be a support to Israel. And you connect with other people from different nations who are representatives of Africa-Israel initiatives that will be able to give you more guidelines how to be able to connect and also to be a part of what we are doing in this end time. The Lord richly bless you. May the God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob, and the God of Zambia be your God. God bless you. Thank you.
Becomes like a flower and withers like a shadow. We shall all go to the way of no return. It's not just a solemn moment, it's a rejoicing time, please. Let's give the Lord a big clap of our hands one more time. We shall all go to the way of no return. It's not just so a moment, it's a rejoicing time, please. Let's give the Lord a big clap of our hands one more time.
In the continuity, that your glory shall overshadow us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. We can all be seated as I invite the choir to be.
Country and outside to minister through worship. In 1993, the Lord appeared to him in a vision and called him to ministry. He was later commissioned by the Lusaka Ministers Fellowship. His family life. In 19, Apostle Malambo had been going to Kenya to minister since 1999. And finally, in 2002, he settled and got married to Reverend Josephine Nyambura Malambo. Apostle Malambo was a family man. He survived by his wife, five children, three boys and two girls, four grandchildren, a brother and a sister. Ministry life. He was the founding executive board member of Africa Israel Initiative, serving as the regional director for Southern Africa. He was also a board member and director of operations of IPWGC Africa, that is International Prayer Warrior Center Africa for SADC region. He was founder and executive director of diverse international ministries. He was the director of international missions of Shiloh Bible College in Kenya. And he was also a mentor, a spiritual father to many, as well as a trainer. He was also a member of Association for Zambians in Kenya. His mission in Kenya, he went there as a missionary. His mission was to impact the body of Christ through sound and balanced gospel by preaching and teaching and writing books and materials to transform lives. His wishes here in Zambia, one of the wishes he had was to build a world mission center to train and support local missionaries, to build a prayer center within the world mission center to impart knowledge of kingdom worship and intercessory to believers. Apostle Malambo fell sick on 4th June 2019 and passed on the 7th of June 2019 at about 08 hours a.m. May his soul rest in peace. Oh,
Some say love.